Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Let's study together. As we all are locked at home due to COVID-19, so I take a decision to share my knowledge with you through my YouTube channel. Please subscribe my channel and like it and share it. Today I will study the English poem Cold Within, written by James Patrick Kinney. So firstly, I will read the stanza one by one and then I will give the information along with the stanza. So let's get started. Six human trapped by happenstance in black and bitter cold, each one possess a stick of wood, or so the story is told. Their dying fire in lead of logs, the first man held back, for the faces round the fire he noticed one was black. Now I will give the information about this stanza. The poet omens on a dramatic note. It attracts our attention at once by the use of diction. The poet says that six humans get trapped by chance in a bitter cold. The poet uses the word human, not people, because he want to refer to the all human beings. The line, six human trapped by happenstance, is to be read carefully. Though the six persons were together in a situation which seems to have been arranged even though it was accidental, that is why the poet used the word happenstance, and even that is arranged, okay? Then the six persons were thus in a situation from which there were no to escape. They were sitting near the fire which was fast dying. The fire which was dying needed to feed with the logs of wood that they each were holding in their hands. The first was a woman, was not ready to renounce her stick of wood to keep the fire burning because she noticed that one of them was black. She did not want to save the black. Thus, she acted out of a racial prejudice. The next man looking across the way saw one not of his church and couldn't bring himself to give the fire his stick of birch. The third one sat in tattered clothes. He gave his coat a hitch. Why should his log be put to use to warm the idle rich? Now, the poet says that the next person in the group was a man who could not persuade himself to give up his stick of wood to help a person of another religion. It is clear that he was a Christian. Okay. Then the third person was a very poor person. He was wearing tattered clothes. He was full of bitterness and envy for the rich. He gave the coat a hitch, in which he signs that he did not warm his stick that should warm the rich one. He thought it would be unjust to give what little he had to help others who had more than he. So he held his stick back. Next, the rich man just sat back and thought of the wealth he had in store and how to keep what he had earned from the lazy, shiftless poor. The black man's face bespoke revenge as the fire passed from his sight. For all he saw in his stick of wood was a chance to spite the white. The next one, the rich man continued to sit back and think of the money he had in his wealth and how could he save it from the lazy poor, right? He did not want to give anything to the underserving people, poor people, though he showed his greed and stinginess. The black man's face showed how much revengeful he was. As the fire was dying, he thought he had the chance to hurt the white people by keeping his stick with him. He clearly suffered from the vice of spite. And the last man of his forlorn group did not accept for game, giving only to those who gave us how he played the game. The logs held tight in that still hands and was proof of human sin. They didn't die from the cold without. They died from the cold within. The last man in the group lacked generosity. As no one else had given his stick, he also decided that he will also not give his stick. In fact, he did nothing except for the gain. As the fire extinguished, all the persons died. They died not because of the cold outside, because of the cold within. They died because they were too selfish to help others. Each of them had a log still in his or her hands, suggesting that no one had renounced sinning, being unkind, or one reason or the other.